I'm going to show you four of the world's most expensive natural herbs. Wait until you hear these insane prices, but also how these herbs can benefit you. So if you're feeling like a baller and you want to splash out on some expensive herbs, watch this video. Let's go. Throughout history, there have been times where the prices of herbs, spices, and flowers have skyrocketed. Like, did you know at one point, tulips sold for approximately 10,000 guilders? At that time, that was equal to the value of a mansion on Amsterdam Grand Canal. This was during the tulip mania of the 1600s, when the prices of tulips just kept going up and up before crashing around 1636. But how about now? What's pricey? And why is it pricey? But also, are there any particular benefits to these insanely expensive herbs? Some obvious expensive herbs, which I'm not going to discuss on this video, include opium poppies and coca leaves, which some serious drugs are made from. I'm not also going to discuss Mary Jane, known to some as marijuana, which can be expensive around the world. These won't make the list for obvious reasons, but what I am going to do is give a top four rundown of some other pricey herbs. So if you like this video, be sure to leave a comment and let me know your thoughts. It's something different from my usual, but with so much going on in the world, I really want to lighten it up with something completely different. So let's get straight into the top four most expensive herbs. At number four on this list, we have Panax ginseng, also known as Asian ginseng or Korean ginseng. Right now in the UK, a kilo of Panax ginseng powder, the pure one, not the extract, that will set you back around £240. That's over $300 for a kilo of a herb. To put that in perspective, Siberian ginseng, also known as Elitiro, another kind of ginseng, will cost you around £50 for exactly the same amount. This is one of the most expensive herbs. Personally, I still buy this herb every so often, but I don't buy it that often due to its price, but it's crazy powerful. So why is this herb so expensive? Well, the reason for its high price is that demand for this herb is continually increasing and there is scarcity in its supply. The main reason for this scarcity is because it takes about 5 to 10 years to mature. And it's also a wild herb, so supply cannot be easily increased as it grows without human intervention. So when the demand is high and the supply is low, as you know, the price will go up. But if you do want to buy Panax ginseng, make sure you buy it from a reputable company as they will practice sustainable cultivation. A quick fun fact for you, Panax ginseng, well, the Panax element comes from the word panacea, which literally translates to cure for all. This herb is powerful. The third most expensive herb is American ginseng. Yes, there are actually a lot of different types of ginseng, and I'm going to make a video one day which discusses the different ones and how they differ. So if that's something you want to see, let me know in the comments and I'll get that done for you ASAP. So what is the cost of American ginseng? Well, American ginseng that's dried will set you back between $800 to $1,600. And there is some places where you can get it for more. And this is per pound. So these prices are no joke. For my UK watchers, £1 literally is 0.45 kilograms. So 450 grams. These are some insane prices for herbs. But both of these herbs are powerful. Both Panax ginseng and American ginseng are some incredibly powerful herbs. But some of you guys may be wondering what the main difference is between the two. Well, it is believed that American ginseng works as a relaxing agent, whereas Panax ginseng has a more of an invigorating effect. And both of these herbs are grown in the wild. American ginseng is native to America. Although now it's grown in other places, it's actually native to the deciduous forest of the eastern United States. Fun fact, did you know that this herb was over harvested in the 1970s and therefore subsequently it was listed as an endangered species? Currently now there are 18 states that issue licenses for its export. Not every single person can go forage it and not every single person can go sell it. In regards to American ginseng, some of the benefits attributed to the root is lower blood pressure, lower cholesterol levels, protection against stress, enhance strength, and it promotes relaxation within the body. Well, with this price tag, is this a herb you're willing to try? You guys can let me know in the comments. All right, moving on to the third most expensive. Let's get a little drum roll. So the third most expensive herb is vanilla. Since we bake with it and it's relatively inexpensive in extract format, we don't actually consider how much the raw version costs. But right now you can buy a kilo of vanilla pods and that will set you back a whopping £820 per kilo. This is insane and wild prices. There's people selling the other kind of herb, their legal version. They could be selling the legal versions and making a lot of money. And one reason why vanilla has gotten so expensive, well, it's because it's hard to grow. The vanilla vines take up to 2 to 4 years to fully mature, and problems with failed crops, terrible weather, made it almost 10 times more expensive than it was a few years ago. But vanilla still has some good benefits, and some of the benefits of vanilla are antiviral, antibacterial, and it has a lot of good antioxidants. But it's also good for your mood, helps you relax, and vanilla is also very high in nutrients. But is it worth the price, or should we continue to bake with the cheaper vanilla extract version? Comment below, let me know your thoughts. So the final and most expensive herb on this list is a herb called saffron. Listen close for the price of this one, guys. This one is insane. A kilo of saffron cost, depending on quality, right, between $1,100 to $11,000 per kilogram. Yes, you heard that right. And that is in today's prices. Not 1,000 years ago, not 500 years ago, today. The reason for this, well, the price has continually increased since 1974. Back then, it averaged around 1,000 per pound or 2,000 per kilogram. But now, as you can see, it's gone up almost 10x. So, is there some good benefits of this extremely expensive herb? Well, some of the health benefits of saffron are it contains a good amount of powerful antioxidants. It may also improve mood. It may also boost mental health. It may aid appetite control, thus helping people lose weight. And it might also boost your eyesight. And it also acts as a bit of an aphrodisiac. But for that price tag, is it worth it? You guys be the judge. Let me know in the comments. So why is it so expensive? Well, simply put, it's because it's extremely labor intensive. It's said that around 80,000 flowers must be grown, cared for, hand harvested and processed just to make 1 pound of saffron. This process requires each flower head be removed by hand. That is crazy. It's very time intensive and hence the big price. I know what you guys are thinking. Okay, so what herb should we buy for Paul? Out of all of these herbs, what is the best gift to buy for Paul because he's such an amazing guy? If you're wondering what to buy for me as a gift, I'll take Panax Ginseng. Thank you and good night. And I want to know which herb you will buy for yourself, which herb you buy for your friends. If, let's say, you won the jackpot today, you got a million in cash and wanted to be a baller, what's the first herb you buy? Let me know in the comments. And guys, if you want to learn a bit more about herbs, click on my face, get my herb guide, and before you go, check out these two videos right here and right here. Guys, health is wealth. I'll see you on the next one. It's your brother Paulo Tote, certified herbalist, nutritionist. Peace.